Hotep community, welcome back to another amazing Wealth Wednesday, Black Wealth Wednesday at that, the Black Supremacy Virtual Manifestation Tour with yours truly, the Metaphysical Morpheus, Rev Shock. Nothing is wrong with Black people. Something happened to Black people. This is not your grandmother's metaphysics. This is lesson number six. So you should absolutely know that this is not your regular metaphysical whatever crap you've been fed for all of these years. So here we go. Let's get into it. We always start off with our opening affirmation of power, prosperity, and protection. I'll say it once, and then you can repeat it with me. I am one with first frequency. I am one with the first thought idea. I am one with the firstborn people. I am one with the only one. Together, please. I am one with first frequency. I am one with the first thought idea. I am one with the firstborn people. I am one with the only one. Ashe, and so it is. This series has been dedicated to my three spiritual mothers, Reverend Dr. Johnny Coleman, who says you are the thinker who thinks the thought, who makes the thing. That's just one of the juggernauts of just a metaphysical maven. And Reverend Dr. Helen Carey, and of course, Nana Dr. Frances Cress Welsing. And I would like to give a special dedication to this particular session that we're gonna have today to Nana Dr. Patricia Newton, who made her transition literally yesterday, and was just a powerhouse, loved her very, very much, had many conversations with her. We were getting ready to work together and do some webinars together on melanin and money. She's the star of Hoppy, the film, and she's just incredible. Her gift to us is unmeasurable. Ashe to the goddess Hotep. So what is first frequency? For those of you who are tuning in for the first time, first frequency of oneness is a culturally specific teaching ministry exclusively for Africans and African Americans. We specialize in healing and removing the ancestral, historical, and incarnate trauma within Africans and African Americans. We help our people reveal their natural and original first frequency signal and vibration. First frequency of oneness is based on science, not self-esteem, and we are a teaching ministry, not a preaching ministry. We help create a spiritual, psychological, and emotional barrier to the hidden signal of racial battle fatigue and racialized domestic terror. And we remove the African and the African American from the effects of their false racial identities, which we call third and fourth frequencies. We also help our family overcome their trauma bonding, their capture bonding, and Stockholm syndrome to whiteness. Who am I? Well, I am Rev Shock. I have a master's degree in metaphysical science and philosophy. I'm the founding minister of First Frequency of Oneness, Science, and Manifestation and Prosperity. Shock stands for Seeking Higher Omnipotent Conscious or Cosmic Knowledge. I'm also the founder of the Shock Metaphysics Virtual Comedic Wisdom School. And many of you know me from being the host of the Philippe Matthews Show. I've authored over 17 books. Professor Kaba Hiawatha Kamene calls me the Marcus Garvey of our time. Mark Victor Hansen, Chicken Soup for the Soul, says I'm the Oprah of Internet. Now, this entire series is based on my master's thesis. Can using metaphysical meditation and affirmation daily heal the trauma of generational poverty in American African Americans? And so the goal of this series, I just kind of came up with this quote that touched me this morning, that we are mystical, magical, first frequency, melanated people, and must learn the process of unlocking and unblocking our historical genetic trauma to create sustained, mystical, magical, first frequency, melanated wealth. That is our goal. That is the mission. Ashe, if you agree. Now, I've always said this, nothing is wrong with Black people. Nothing is wrong with us. Something happened to us. We are not sick people. We're sick from being exposed to sick people. And we really have a deep understanding of that. So what we're going to be doing today, foundational learning level six, we're going to learn how to collapse time. by mastering the laws of cause and effect. So when you don't know your time, you are outside of your mind. I might have a rap future. I might get a mixtape done. I think that rhymes. When you don't know your time, you are outside of your mind. Now, I had this conversation a few days ago with someone because my last sermon, we talked about affirmations and denials. We talked about shock theology. And so the question came up, and I said, where in ancient Africa, and I said, I'll give you $1,000 if you can find any ancient African text that our ancients sat around or walked around saying affirmations like, I am rich. They were already rich and wealthy. This is who we are, first frequency, where we come from. Their needs were met. There was no separation of time, and they collapsed time using the laws we call today cause and effect. So we're going to really get into this and get an understanding of what this means and how we can move from the consciousness of why to a consciousness of why not. A synthesis of the micro and macro. That is what cause and effect is. Now, as above, so below, as within, so without, also understanding the law of correspondence. When we look at micro and macro physics, we create a metaphysical process and journey. The Kabbalah says every cause has its effect. Every effect has its cause. Everything happens according to law. Chance is but a name for law, not recognized. Love that. That's extremely powerful. Very true. There are many planes of causation, but nothing escapes the law. And that is a fact. So when we look at this first frequency cosmic time signal that we talk about, I want to talk about what happens when it's interrupted. The ancient Africans, such as the Dogon and the Twa, had no outside or opposing first frequency signal interruption prior to the second frequency Amu showing up and interrupting their time. Now, if you've ever watched my show with Professor Kaba, you will know he has a quote that he always says, and that is, before we were so rudely interrupted. And so when we... just was with the brother last night, love him to pieces. And so when we so rudely interrupted, there was a point where I call the consciousness before the conflict. We had a consciousness before the conflict. We're now dealing with, as a result of the Ma'afa, a consciousness after the conflict. And so it's already pre-programmed into our genetic and ancestral memory. We are simply struggling with our genetic memory. This is a very interesting concept, family. What I want you to really recognize and realize is, and the power of this and why I developed this entire process. When we look at the second frequency Amu, they are fighting genetic, being genetically recessive. They're fighting their genetics. We're fighting a genetic memory. A genetic memory can be changed. We can alter our genetic memory. We can change our genetic memory tags or epigenetic tags. They can't change their genetics. So we need to look at that and understand what we are up against is not as big and scary as most people like to make it think. The reason that they are able to go extinct, the reason that they're not able to reproduce, the reason that they're moving themselves off the planet is because they have a genetic issue. And when you're genetically recessive, you are going to wreak havoc because you're going to try to survive by any means necessary and at all cost. And so as a result of the original people, first frequency people, we don't have a fear of extinction. We don't have because we're genetically superior. That's where the term black supremacy comes from. And this is science, by the way, like I said, not self-esteem, not putting anybody down or throwing any culture under the bus. But I'm just laying out some facts and understanding to you that one is genetic, one is epigenetic. We are dealing with genetic memory, and we can change and alter those genetic memories and create new ones that overwrite or override the current genetic tags or epigenetic tags that we're dealing with. First frequency African-American and Africans must learn not to succumb to the lower frequencies, which is second, third, and fourth, of activity, so you become a master of time instead of a slave of time. Now, here's the thing. What happened when they came out of the ice? They stole our time. And I have to give this concept to Brother Patah Seeker Asar, who first, when I talked to him on the phone, that was the first thing that he said to me. And it stuck with me that they stole our time. They didn't just steal us, they stole our time. And as a result, it interrupted our first frequency cosmic signal. We had already mastered all the laws of the universe, as well as we learned how to collapse time, making us the first metaphysical masters of cause and effect. So we're going to get into this really, really deep today, family. When you don't know what time it is, you are discombobulated and out of your mind. Carter G. Woodson calls this dual consciousness because second frequency whiteness caused the African and African-American to lower in frequency and become subservient to second frequency. So you have to understand that the ice devolved these first frequency Africans over 100,000, 300 years into what we now refer to as second frequency Amu or European. In order for them to survive, they had to divide and conquer and create a lower level than they are, which is that third and fourth frequency. Because we're born first frequency, we're born as gods and goddesses. Right now, we're having a third and fourth frequency situation and experience. But we are the original masters of time, cosmic time, and cause and effect. So this process caused the African-American to become bipolar in our actions and behaviors. As a result, Carl Jung says, what we do not understand breaks off and becomes more primitive. We became primitive in our nature and behavior because we're living in a false identity, a false sense of self, a false reality, and a false racial construct, which makes the African and African-American perpetually out of sync with our first frequency cosmic time. Now, in order to create manifestable intentions, we must learn how to master our time by learning how to collapse our time, which we're going to go through, which means we must become metaphysical masters of the comedic understanding of cause and effect. Now, everything you want, everything you could desire, you already have. You are simply not frequency specific to it, which is why it is not showing up in your current experience or reality. Dr. Wade Nobles constantly says we suffer from a shattered consciousness and fractured identity. Your best life and best self already exists in first frequency. The African and African American has been socially engineered to use our first frequency signal against ourselves, keeping us in a perpetual trauma time loop until we run out of time and die. Now, this is about taking our time back, collapsing our time, putting this in a way that you may have not seen it before. And so I want you to understand that your just over broke income, which is your job, is an illusion of time and space that has been encoded in you at birth, and if you want to go into epigenetics and genetic memory, pre-birth. Pre-birth is the genetic memory or lies and illusions encoded in you before conception, causing you to be born with a certain DNA proclivities and propensities and expressions for a life filled with poverty, financial struggle, lack, and limitation. In other words, all of this financial struggle that we have been dealing with in the family, poverty, all of that is learned behavior, pre-programmed behavior, and just learning how to get a job. Let's get into this really deep. You were taught how to work for time, as opposed to have time work for you. Second frequency people stole our cosmic time and forced us into a chronological time way of thinking. This is why most of us live paycheck to paycheck. You are taught how to pay for your time twice. First, you go to school, you get an education to get a job or just over broke, which is about 1 to 4 years. Then you are taught how to go into debt. You are taught how to go into debt. Did I say you were taught how to go into debt? This is a learned behavior. You're taught how to go into debt by using your just over broker, your job, time to pay off your debt for the time that you got your education. Once your brain has been trained to work for time, you are now a slave. The goal of second frequency systems is for you to simply run out of time before you figure this out, before you figure, as I said before, what happened to you? Nothing's wrong with you. What happened to you? What happened to us? Nothing is wrong with us. Something happened to us. You become addicted to the belief that you will have wealth, happiness, and peace when you die in the afterlife. This causes you to unconsciously invoke learned helplessness, whereby you never try to beat the system because you do not know how to break your brain or the system. You are now locked between what's called the causal realm, which is the thought, the idea, the intention. I want wealth. I want more money. I want financial freedom. And the physical effect realm, which is the demonstration, the physical manifestation, or the result of what it is you wish to cause. No result equals no manifestation. You have not learned how to collapse time. Now, if this is making sense to you, family, put a hell yeah, you know, that's my thing. Put a hell yeah in the chat so that I can get an understanding, even though I can't see you in the chat just yet, but I will read those chat transcripts after I am done. And also just want to send a shout out to all of you. Thank you so much for the love and for the support of this work. It's what wakes me up in the morning. So I just want to just love you up and big you up on that. Thank you so much. The science of collapsing time and space is knowing the problem and the solution must exist simultaneously. Now, that's extremely powerful because you have to understand if you have a problem, there is a solution that must exist simultaneously. If you have a solution, there must be a problem that exists simultaneously. All experiences come in full quantum. We did that in the last lesson plan, and so in shock theology. I won't go into it again, but you can go back, watch that lesson so you can understand how every problem and challenge that we have, there is a solution that is right there. We're just not frequency specific to it. We are taught that sacrifice and reward is measured through time and space. You go to school, then you get a job. You get a job, then you get paid every 2 weeks. You save your money, then you get rich. You can't have your cake and eat it too. You won't experience heaven until you die. You work hard and sacrifice in the physical life and then experience wealth and heaven in the afterlife. Rev Shock is saying, this is bullshit. This is the lie that they have programmed us to believe. This is a lie. I don't care what your faith system is. I don't care where you were born, who you were born to. This is a lie. You, me, all of us, first frequency people, are supposed to be able to manifest our cause and effect immediately. We are not supposed to die with our music still in us. So I'm just putting that out there. And if that makes sense to you, give me another hell yeah or put some ones in there. Just do something. Just say something. So now, collapsing time, creation has been created. Nothing's missing. Let's go into this concept. Let's get an understanding. Creation has been created, meaning that any reality that we can fathom already exists within the quantum database, which is the Akashic Records or the Akashic Chronicles, as it's called. We do not have the capacity to outthink or create that which has created us. Therefore, success is scientific at the quantum level of understanding. This is what the Twa, the Dogon, this is what we did. This is who we are. See, it's crazy because I use the term what we did, but it's really what we are. Because there is no separation between ancient Africa and now. There is no separation between time and space. The reason we're able to access our ancestors lets you know that you are able to collapse time. Think about that. The fact that you're able to do that. So anything you could possibly want to manifest already exists. Otherwise, you would not have the capacity to think it, desire it, or conceive it. Let's go into that for a minute. Now, when we talk about creation has been created, and we talk about a group of people that the creator decided to manifest first on this planet. And we're talking, you know, some people are saying 250,000 years, 250,000 years, some are saying millions of years that we've been here. We have mastered heaven and earth. We have mastered all sciences. We have mastered the micro, which is microphysics or quantum physics. We've mastered the macro or the astrophysics. As a result, we have everything that we need, and whatever the creator has created, we are able to tap into that and co-create with the creator. So there's nothing you can think of that is not possible within the creator's mind, or what we call universal mind, or the all, whatever terminology you want to use for this quantum field, for this quantum soup. This is what's meant by when the mystics end their meditations with "it is done" or "and so it is." It means it's already done. It's already manifested. It just has to take shape and form to be demonstrated in physical form in your experience and reality. Now, if nothing is missing because creation has been created, then every level of wealth, success, and happiness you and I could ever want or imagine already exists as a possibility in the universal quantum soup. We can only reproduce and co-create by harnessing what already is and use it to evolve as a species. Simply put, there are no secrets to success, only endless combinations and endless possibilities. Ashe. Now, when we understand this concept of creation has been created, and this comes from my book, I think I wrote this thing back in 2002, literally on an airplane coming back from Sacramento to Chicago, and I wrote these eight principles, or seven or eight principles. I don't even remember. I've written too many doggone books, but this is a very powerful principle because no scientist has ever invented or ever will original fire, or, you know, natural gas, metal, wood, or wind. This is cosmic work. This is God's creation. This is the creator's creation. In fact, everything that we experience in life is merely a highly evolved co-creation with what divine quantum has already given us the power to choose into existence. Just because you are not experiencing wealth, success, and happiness that you desire at your current point of observation, it does not mean it doesn't exist at another level or point of observation. Remember, we talked about this in the last sermon about the reality, the identity crisis, and moving from one concentric sphere to another, moving from one reality to the other. Everything you could possibly want, desire, exists already. We just have to become frequency specific to it. So it's just waiting for the arrival of our consciousness to catch up to our reality. If you have not reached your dream, your desires and inspirations, it's merely because you have not fully embraced the acceptance and feeling deserving of manifesting at that level of reality. And so we must learn how to individually and collectively raise our consciousness. Now, that's a big word we all hear. What is consciousness? What is consciousness? In shock philosophy, principle number 5, consciousness is energy and capacity. And let's go a little deeper into understanding what consciousness is. It's your expression of first frequency God possibility as you see God possibility filtered and tempered through your thoughts, beliefs, and experiences. Nothing can happen to you until you allow it to happen through you. We understand that. Now, when we look at consciousness and then we talk about capacity, I like to use the analogies of a hard drive. Capacity is the amount of first frequency God possibility you naturally hold and occupy in thought without thinking about it or trying it. So it's basically just your consciousness, your capacity and consciousness of what you look at as a reality, and what realities do you want to experience? Who do you want to morph into? What is your best self? What is your next self? Not even your best self, just what is your next self? That is held in consciousness. In order to have more of life, you must have the capacity to harness and maintain life. This is called consciousness. Consciousness is having the capacity of first frequency God power, first frequency God potential in your heart, mind, and soul, so that when the opportunities to expand who you are arise, you will have the ability to accept and feel deserving of the very thing that you desire, rather than sabotage and reject that which you do desire. And that's one, I think we talked about that in our first session, as a matter of fact. So go back and look at that and take a deeper understanding of how and why we sabotage ourselves. When you hear the term wealth is consciousness, it sounds very esoteric. But when you describe consciousness analogous to gigabytes on a hard drive, you may begin to make sense of what consciousness really is. Now, if you remember, because I'm old enough to remember, when a 2 gig hard drive was the largest amount of storage you could have on a PC. I remember that. And you could put all of your documents, files, presentations, and information on it and still have room left over. Well, 2 gig hard drive now gave way to a 10 and then so on and so forth. It became obsolete because the data, the capacity of that level of consciousness has expanded. That's what it means by an expanded consciousness. So are you operating on a lower gigabyte of storage? You know, in other words, you might want a terabyte lifestyle, but you only have a 2 gig consciousness and capacity. If that makes sense, put a hell yeah in the chat for me, because the goal is to expand your consciousness and expand your capacity so that which you desire becomes natural and the natural order in your reality. The larger the capacity of the consciousness, the more information energy can be stored. You can store more possibility and potential with a 400 gig consciousness than you can with a 2 gig consciousness. If consciousness is the amount of God possibility, potential you can naturally hold and occupy in thought, then the more consciousness you have, the more potential you have. Therefore, the more normal and natural wealth, success, and happiness becomes to support and match that level of consciousness. This is, of course, in the book, The Shock Philosophy. Now, collapsing time, intention, and intentionality. Let's get in it. Three phases of manifestation is intention, attention, and release. Intention, attention, and release. You probably have a pen and paper already. I should have probably prefaced that. You might want to take some notes on this one, okay? Now, what is intention? In my interview with Dr. Wayne Dyer, he says a strong presence, intention is a strong presence or aim accompanied by a determination to produce a desired result. Intentionality, in his book, The Power of Intention, is in the universe, there is an immeasurable, indestructible force, which shamans call intent. And absolutely everything that exists in the entire cosmos is attached to intent by a connecting link. Now, if that is not the Akashic records, if that is not the Twa and the Dogon mapping out the entire process of as above, so below, I don't know what is. But there it is. That is what we are. This is what first frequency looks like. So when we talk about installing an intention, to properly install an intention and manifest it, you must change the way your brain stores and activates information. Currently, the African and African-American has been socially engineered to store information and education as entertainment, not self-actualizing, self-fulfilling, and self-prophesizing demonstration. So this is where that signal interruption comes in that we talked about earlier, family. You go through all of these webinars, you buy all of these books, you watch all of these shows, you follow all the scholars and scholarship, but you're still in the same place. Why? Because your brain has been trained to store this knowledge and information as entertainment, not activated process to be demonstrated. So we're going to go into how to change that. You have been conditioned to separate the cause of your intention, which are your goals, dreams, ideas, from the effect or the manifestation of your intention, goals, dreams, and ideas. This is due to the successful social engineering, slave breeding, colonization, domestication of the African and African-American mind. And nervous system, historically, generationally, to separate you from being in control and a master of your life and time. Now, Dr. Coleman says, live the wishful dream already fulfilled. Remember, we talked about creation being created. Live it. Imagine yourself already in possession of the intention or the cause or the goal that you wish to manifest using the science of pre-commitment. This is the speed at which you pre-commit to your intention determines your velocity of collapsing the cause between the effect, collapsing time. Now, so let's say you have a dream, idea, concept. I want a certain level of wealth. I want a certain type of home, what have you. It might take you 50 years to get it. Well, it shouldn't take you 50 years to get it. It should not take you that long. We should be able to intend something, which is going into cause, creating a pre-commitment to that cause and intention that is so powerful, so strong, that we start to literally walk into that new home, walk into that, step into that new car, step into that new reality immediately. This is the concept, the process of collapsing our time so that we don't run out of time. Research shows that people, this is Dr. Gleb Sapersky on my radio show. He's a disaster and disaster avoidance expert. He says research shows that people are much more motivated to use anything that they've committed to if they don't have any other options. So he says any listeners on the show who are thinking about making a major choice, this would be really good for them to not leave themselves a back out to back out of. If they're sure the choice is good, don't leave yourself options. This is a part of pre-commitment. One of the things that we have a problem with is one, committing to something and finishing what we start. And that is because we are out of sync, out of time. And as a result, everything chases our mind. We are looking for the next shiny object and we never manifest. We collect a lot of data. Zig Ziglar says, are you a wandering generality or a meaningful specific, right? And so when you just collect all of these webinars and seminars and books and what have you, oh, it's impressive. But what do you have to show for all of this collection of data and information? It's that something you have not pre-committed to, because now you're addicted to the searching for information. So you've moved out of cause. You're kind of in purgatory, a causal purgatory, if you will, where your reality is just looping. You're running on a treadmill, standing still, or you're just standing in place and running in place, and you're not moving anywhere. But you look busy. You look like you really got it going on, but you're really not doing anything because you're trapped in time. You're frozen in time. And that is a result of what we're talking about. So the next phase from intention is the attention. So you have to give an intention attention to remove distractions, create the environment of first frequency intention. You must become frequency specific to the intention, increasing the intention's gravitational pull by increasing your frequency and speed. And so what I mean by that is that you've got to go home. What does that mean when you go home? It means you have to go back to the darkness. You got to go back to black. You've got to go back into the cosmic womb from which all creation has been created. Remember, we talked about this, I believe, in our first or second session, that we must invoke dark matter and dark energy. Now, I personally, this is what I do. I have a bunch of different types of blindfolds. and I have some noise canceling headphones that I put on. I blindfold myself and I put my headphones on. I block out all sound. I go into the darkness, and that's how I manifest the reality. In fact, that's how I manifest this ministry. That's how I've manifest 17 books. That's how I've manifest my show. That's how I've manifested this series. I go into the darkness because that is where we come from. Here is something I want to give you, and I'm going to be doing another lesson sermon on this and teaching on this, but I want you to really get this, family, about the power of, well, the Black Room also. I want you to go, and if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get access to this PowerPoint, and you'll be able to click on these links that are in here, and you'll be able to get Brother Billy Bird's The Black Room. He has an audio book, and he has an ebook. I recommend that you do both because they work kind of in tandem, and they help you block out all of the other frequencies, second frequency, racial battle fatigue, third and fourth frequency, and it puts you right back into the cosmic womb. Here's the thing. Everything comes from, if you listen to Professor Kaba, he will tell you a story that he had with Dr. Sebi, and that Dr. Sebi told him, says, before you can talk about melanin, you must talk about carbon. And carbon comes from dark matter and dark energy. Here's something that I don't think people really get, but I'm going to give it to you, and you tell me how it lands for you, and that is this. If you do not love the African-American, Black, melanated, carbon-based people, then you don't love God. You don't love your creator. You are in a false loop, and that's why you created a false white boy on a stick. Because if you don't love the original people, even your Bible says, honor thy mother, thy father. Thy mother, thy father is an African king and an African queen, God, goddess. As above, so below, as within, so without. Everything comes from the Black. If you do not love your original people, you don't go to glory, you just go. So I'm just gonna give that to you. If that makes sense to you, family, put an ashe in the chat for me. I can't see it, but I'll see it later. All right, now let's create symbology in your Black Room of your intention. And you do this in secret and read and watch and listen and manifest. Look at all the scholars and the leading thinkers so you can begin to seep all of this information into you. And the reason I say do it in secret is because you don't want to tell anybody what you're doing so they can discourage you, send you bad energy and bad thoughts and just try to distract you. And, even though we are people to people in our axiology and person to person, that worked in Africa. When we are here on this continent, we have to engage in what I call a suspended axiology. And that is we have to first fortify ourselves before we can fortify someone else. And so we can't share our go up goals and go up process with everyone that is around us because we're so fractured in our identity and shattered in our consciousness using Dr. Wade Noble's understanding that we end up harming each other as opposed to healing each other. And so we have to get ourselves first into that first frequency, understand that, and get ourselves together. Then we can come out into the world and get everybody else together. You must go into shock, seek higher omnipotent conscious and cosmic knowledge, and program your brain like you program a computer. Now, Dr. Frances Cress Welsing refers to this as your brain computer. She says, once the symbol is formed, it is capable of acting upon the brain computer, which receives it as an energy or data message. This message affects the end product of behavior as carried forth in any area of human activity. The symbol, in turn, acts upon the external environment. Now, we have negative symbols. We're creating positive symbols. In that Black Room, you're going to, in that book, Brother B-Man, Billy Bird, is going to give you all of the things that you need to have in that Black Room. But the most important thing is that there cannot be any second frequency images, any second frequency sounds, because the sound or the tenor of their voice or speaking voice or singing voice is a reinforcement of our trauma, because it's not a natural tone in Africa. It is not a natural tone in first frequency. So just sometimes hearing it, listening to a television commercial or radio commercial that is from second frequency Amu, it damages us. And that is the work of Dr. William A. Smith, Racial Battle Fatigue. Now, when we want to begin manifesting this new reality, creating intention, creating cause, first causation, we want to bombard, saturate, and overwhelm our senses to the point that we develop what's called secondary syndrome. I've talked about this before, but I wanted to go in a little deeper. There's an actual thing called medical student's disease. It's called a syndrome, a third year syndrome, second year syndrome, intern syndrome. And it's a psychological condition among medical trainees that experience the symptoms of the disease or diseases they are studying. Now, I want to flip the script on you, family. I want you to study cause and effect and intentionality to the point where you start to have the symptoms of manifestation. Did you get that? I want you to study cause and effect and intention and intentionality and collapsing time to the degree that you become positively sick with it and you start to manifest the symptoms. This is what happens when you bombard your system with information. You're supposed to feel overwhelmed. You want to be saturated. You want to be overwhelmed and full. This is how we start to reprogram, create new epigenetic tags. Remember, they, second frequency, are suffering from genetics and recessive genetics. We are suffering simply from genetic memory. Memories can change. We can do this. We can manifest this, and this is how. So there's a process I use that because I was a search engine optimization guy, an internet guy, we kind of all mapped out, you know, how Google does so well in searching. And they do well in searching because they have three algorithmic processes and mathematical equations that's known as relevance, significance, and value. So I took that concept and I said, let's apply that to every aspect of my life. If it's not relevant, if it's not significant, if it doesn't have value, why am I engaging in it? Why am I keeping this in my reality? Why am I keeping this in my experience? And that is friends and family. So when I engage with someone, the first thing that I'm thinking of, is this relevant? Is this significant? Does it have value? Is this moving me forward? Is this supplying my needs? Is this interaction? Is this experience that I have a choice to go into? Is this making me a wandering generality or a meaningful specific? What's the relevance, significance, and value? Start looking at that. Conversations that you might be having on the phone, is it relevant, significant? Does it have value? Is it wasting your time or is it collapsing your time? Is it wasting your time or is it collapsing your time? So when we understand this concept, we also have to create, in terms of collapsing time, is we have to, and creating an intention, we have to create a powerful why, right? Les Brown says, if you can create a strong enough why, you can endure almost anyhow, right? Why do you want to manifest this intention? Why do you need or desire this intention? Why should you need and desire this intention? And these are things you want to write down as you begin to get very frequency specific as to what you want to manifest. Why do you want to manifest it? Right? And you don't want to limit yourself on the manifestation. I want more money so I can pay bills. No, then you're always going to have just enough money to pay bills. You have to have a specific why, and it has to go deeper than just the current reality that you are facing, living, and dealing with right now. So then that's where we get into the last phase of manifestation, and that is the law of release, learning how to let go and let God. Now, we expect abundance, but hold no anxiety of the outcome, right? Ma'at, the reason Ma'at is a feather is because it's the scale is there, is because a feather, if you hold it too tight, you'll crush it. But if you hold it too loosely, it will fly away or blow away in the wind. And so this is what it means to be in release. Let it go. Once you create the intention, once you give it the proper attention, let it go into the quantum soup. Let it expect the abundance. Live the wishful dream already fulfilled. Know that it is manifesting and that it will become a physical experience immediately. Moving into a state of absolute certainty and expectancy. Keep your mouth shut and your third eye open. All right. We talk too damn much. We tell everybody our dreams, goals, aspirations, what we're getting ready to do, how we're going to do it. And then the next thing you know, 20 years has passed, 30 years, 40, 50 years have passed. You haven't done a damn thing. Why? Because you keep running your damn mouth. Keep your mouth shut and open up your third eye. Identify and remove external trauma. Okay, that will create anxiety. And so wrapping this up and winding it down, there's two levels of trauma, internal and external. So we have, and this is where I want you, I think it's our second session where you can go back and go into deep into understanding these types of trauma, but epigenetic, genetic trauma, genetic memory, decontextualized trauma, vicarious and ghosting trauma. These are internal traumas perpetrated by PTSS, post-traumatic slave syndrome, what Dr. Obadashaka refers to as P68HF, post-1968 hostile forces that came down upon us in this continent and created new epigenetic tags of poverty, lack, limitation, financial struggle. Then we have to deal with what Dr. Nzinga Dalila refers to as RBTSIV, which is race-based traumatic stress, injury, and violence, which creates RBF, the hidden signal, racial battle fatigue. And so when we understand nothing is wrong with us, family, something happened to us. And it's still happening. We're not sick people. We're sick from being captured, corralled, and controlled by sick people. That being said, if you are ready for first frequency, I would love for you to become a member of our Patreon. If you're looking for a virtual teaching ministry home, consider these following options because I would love to be with you. One, of course, just join our mailing list and being in that first frequency, digital frequency, if you will, and online frequency. And of course, we have a membership in first frequency, and we also have a visitors package that you can download and get deeper information onto what the ministry is, what we're about, how we're going to manifest this new level of thinking and reality. You can also join us and receive special never before released metaphysical trainings and interviews that I've had over the years. But I've had some of these interviews when I was assimilated. I'm getting ready to do a teaching lesson on the sixfold stages to mental freedom from a metaphysical understanding. When I was assimilated with a Black identity, I had access to all of these people like Deepak Chopra, Wayne Dyer, Marianne Williamson, and so on and so forth. And so I got a lot of information from them. But what I understood about that European influence, I then had to Africanize it. Once I took that information and Africanized it, now I'm sharing it back with the family from an African-centered consciousness and understanding. And as a result, it's absolutely powerful and frequency specific. So thank you for understanding this and being a part of this. Now, of course, you know, I'm always going to tell you, practice frequency specificity. I do this every day. So I invoke the law of seven. I repeat my affirmation of power, prosperity, and protection seven times a day and 7 days a week. And so let's do it. I am one with first frequency. I am one with the first thought idea. I am one with the firstborn people. I am one with the only one. Ashe, and so it is. And so please subscribe and like and share this content, family. I absolutely adore you, love you. And Uncle Job Seneb, we'll see you next time for another amazing Wealth Wednesday. Hotep community.